I grew up in the English countryside. My mother was a botanist, and frequent walks out in nature, identifying plants, taking samples from rivers and streams and looking at the microbes under the microscope, really gave me a fascination for the interactions between plants and microbes and for the natural world. My name is Laura Grenville-Briggs Didymus, and I'm a professor of integrated plant protection. I'm a molecular plant pathologist with a background in microbial genetics, and my research concerns fungal-like organisms and fungi that cause diseases in plants, and also those that can be used as biological control agents to mitigate those diseases. Crop diseases are a real threat to our crops, to food security, and they contribute significantly to world hunger. If we can come up with ways to mitigate those diseases while also protecting the environment by reducing the use of chemical pesticides and by integrating biological approaches and low-risk compounds, we can really help to provide more food for the world in a more sustainable way that also protects the environment. When I'm not at work, I really enjoy being out in nature, in the countryside, walking and hiking with my family and my big white fluffy Samoyed dog. I also enjoy photographing those landscapes and the environment that we're walking in. I also enjoy playing the transverse flute, and I recently learned some Swedish folk music to help me to better connect with my new home and my new culture that I am delighted to be living in. There's so much we don't know about how plants get sick and about how microbes interact with plants on a deep level. So I think it's really interesting to be able to find out answers to these basic science questions, but also to be able to apply those into real life situations to have an impact on our food production all over the world. And if we can lift some people out of poverty, and if we can provide more food for the world, then that's a fantastic job that we're doing. If we can also understand something new and interesting in basic science, well, that's an amazing combination, in my opinion.